Hi guys, welcome back to Siri TV. I'm Martha, but the usual host with the most. It's been a while since I posted, guys. You know, I needed to take a little bit of a breather. I've been so exhausted, so I just needed to take a bit of that breather and stuff. So we're back. Let's continue where we left. So today's episode, I actually want us to review our personal finances, guys. We're getting into the second quarter of the year, so it's time to start reviewing where we are now as compared to when we started in January. If you did start in January and you're trying to plan and budget and do things properly, it's time to review. But if you haven't done anything yet, or you haven't actually touched on anything yet regarding your personal finances, it's still not too late to start. But today we're going to be talking about reviewing. So even if you haven't started, this will also help you on you starting. So let's do our quarterly review of our personal finances. Where do we start with our reviewing? Yeah, how have we been doing for the past 3 months? What have we been doing? This is January, February, March. So far, what have we been up to? So we're going to draw what we call your personal income statement. Okay, your personal income statement is basically just reviewing how you've been using your money. Your income, this is basically your net income, not your gross, because the gross, obviously some of it has been charged on your payslip. So this time we're talking about your net income, the money that actually goes into your bank account and credits your salary at the end of the month. What have you been doing since January? Have you actually been crediting that money? What money has been crediting to your account? What have you been doing with it? And that is not budgeting, but rather now reviewing your personal income statement. So where do we start to review our personal income statement? Very first step, print your bank statements, guys. Print your bank statement from January to date, okay? And start ticking what's been happening in the bank, okay? And just see what, okay, I received my January and February salaries. What did I do with them? What exactly did I do with them? Now that is reviewing your expenses, your income statement. Basically now your salary versus the expenses. Now that you need to just possibly just highlight, okay, this is what I did, this is what I did. Now, once you've done that, now I need you to draw up an income statement. What do you do by drawing up income statement? Write your salary, okay, I've received this much, and look at it, okay, this is what I spent my money on. You can even do it on a spreadsheet so that you can actually calculate itself. And once you calculate, it calculates itself, it will make total expenses and your total income. Remember, your income, if you have other sources of income coming in besides your salary, maybe you have rental property that's coming in recorded as well, so that you can actually account for every cent and actually see what happened to your money. If you are that person where you're like, can't think now what happened to my money, but I've earned a salary, I've earned a couple of money is this month, but I don't know what happened to my money. Go to your income statement. That's the one that will reflect. That is the one that will tell you your exact position that you have actually done with your money. Now, if you're a person that actually withdraws money a lot, I would ask you to actually try and not withdraw money a lot, because most of the time what happens when you actually withdraw money, you do not remember what you did with that money. So that is what can be quite inconveniencing, and then you are not able to see your exact position of exactly what you've done with your money. So going forward, try and swipe more often or make bank transfers more often to pay your bills, so that you remember what you've actually done. Or for once you have mobile banking, try and use the mobile banking facility, so that you can actually be able to trace what, this is who I sent the money to, this is what I did, versus withdrawing. Okay, now reflect. Once you've now seen, you are reflecting, you're like, oh geez man, I spend so much on groceries. Yeah, so it really shows that sometimes your grocery bill, I know that is actually the biggest bill, to be honest, the house bill, household bill, meaning the groceries bill, that is actually where the money goes. So then you are able to realize, what was I buying most of the time that I'm incurring so much costs. So you are able to realize, okay, I'm actually spending about 3K on groceries. Should I be spending that much? What am I actually buying? Start keeping receipts, and you're able to also reflect and see, okay, this is what I'm also spending on. But at least bank statements will definitely remind you of where you have spent your money. If you've been buying a lot of things that you do not need, then you are able to also reflect and say, you know what, this is where my money is going, and you are able to change that, right? So once you've done that, then you are able to now say, okay, now what can I do to make it better? If you're not happy with how it's going so far, then you're like, okay, what can I do? What can I do to make it better, right? Now, it means now that you have reflected, you know where your money is going, reduce where the money is going, and it's not necessary for it to go there. Reduce the money that is going to where it's not necessary that it should be going. It shouldn't be going to unnecessary things that you can do without. One of the best advices that I've gotten on, let's say now you are wondering where your money is going and you're just like, you know, guys, I'm just up here with money, I don't know what's happening. Stop spending. For a minute, just stop spending on things that you don't need. Just the minute your salary goes in, this is now going forward. Except now you've seen where you're going. Going forward, write down exactly what you need to be paid for. This is your fixed cost. This is your school fees, your rental. This time, try and budget less amount on groceries and remove the things that you can do without. Try and use things wisely in the home so that they don't finish faster, so that you don't need to go buy many times. That's what you need to do. Those are the things to look at, okay? You've realized what it is, now reduce it. Electricity, why are you buying so much in electricity? Literally, guys, just observe what is chowing your power in your home. Literally stock your house if you have to. But what is it that is chowing power? Switch off the geyser and see what this thing is chowing power. Maybe let me use it for an hour, if not, instead of the whole day or more than 2 hours, right? Start to look at things that are actually showing your power. If it's just your pool pump that is showing your power, or too much, see if you can set it on a timer so that it actually doesn't chow too much of your power. It depends on a lot of things, guys. Are you using an electrical stove versus gas stove? Those are things that could be chowing your power, and you can reduce your cost of power. Are you driving around unnecessarily as well? That could reduce your gas bill as well. What else can reduce your expenses so that you can avail your money? You need to be able to see some extra money that you can use to save and invest, or even clear your debts if you are being overwhelmed with debt. So that's how you actually avail the money for those things and avail space for you to breathe more. Just stop spending on things that you don't need. Like, you know, guys, if you can do without alcohol for at least a few months, just to see what, guys, no, I need to see where I am, because I need you to get to this point. I need you to get to a point where you are, you know, dividing your money into percentages, basically how it's supposed to be. And once you've budgeted well and making sure that you've cut down on your costs, you've availed money for things, then you're able to say, you know what, 50% of this money, of this income of mine, I'm going to be taking into the necessities. This is how it's best for you to plan for your money. Necessities, these are the basic necessities at home, your rental, your groceries, and 50% of it, okay? And then 10% should be going to your savings. Another 10%, this is my opinion, to your investments. We're already sitting on 70%. Another 10% giving, guys. Life is all about balance. If you don't give, you actually then also, you're not gonna get anything. So learn to be a giver as well. So 10% giving, and also 10% take it to your self-development account as well. This is your education, all right? So this is very, very important to have that balance. And then the last remaining 10%, make sure it's your treat, guys. Treat yourself every single month, because if you don't do that, you feel like you're not working for anything, right? So that is how the balance should be. I'll repeat that again. 50% goes to your necessities, the next 10% goes to your savings, 10% goes to your savings and investments, we're sitting at 70%. The next 10% goes to giving, right? Now we're sitting at 80%. The next 10% goes to your education, and then the next 10% goes to your treat account, okay? Your education meaning your your self-development education account, because you need to self-develop yourself, right? You need to get to that point where that's how you are actually budgeting your money. That's the point that you need to get to. But if it's still difficult when you're trying to adjust, start by reducing what you don't need right now, and then you'll get to that point of having this kind of balance when you are actually budgeting going forward. Remember, we've been reflecting on our income statement. Now we need to reduce so that we plan going forward. So please start planning for your April. This is end of this month salary. Plan for it. April, March, this is March salary, April salary going forward. Start planning and actually start seeing that you are getting better with your money. Yeah, this is just basically just it for now. The next time I want us to talk about how to create another source of income. Yeah, and yeah, we're going to be talking about a lot of personal finance things that we can do, guys, to improve ourselves, to get better, and etc. etc. Yeah, I wish you all the best in everything that you do, personal finances wise. Remember to be kind always. Bye for now.